Welcome all aviation professionals, all aircraft pilots, type-rated examiners and type-rated instructors, all B1 and B2 engineers, airframe and avionics one. Welcome again to my aviation training solution for today. Your host is always Haysam Ali and I am an aviation technical instructor. Today's topic is very interesting as we are going to call the fuel tank safety procedures or what it called the CDCCLs. Number one, what is the CDCCLs? CDCCLs are features of the fuel system design that need to be maintained throughout all the service life of the aircraft in order to assure that any unsafe condition will not develop. Again, what is the CDCCLs? CDCCLs are new regulations boosted by Easa and FAA to ensure or to address the fuel tank explosion issue. They found that the aircraft, when it is parked on the gate or while in the mid-air without any impact, the fuel tank may explode. So they put or they work together on the CDCCLs. So number two, what is the approaches of the CDCCL? Or how they do approach the CDCCLs, EASA and FAA. The approaches of the CDCCLs are flammability reduction and ignition source prevention. Again, they are flammability reduction and ignition source prevention. What about these two approaches or where they come from? They come from the fire triangle. If you need to recall the CDCCLs, remember the fire triangle. As the problem is that aircraft fuel tanks suffer from fire. So the fire triangle are developed within the fuel tank. Inside the fuel tank, there is fuel or fuel vapor, oxygen or air for ventilation, and a spark may be generated from fuel tank probes and sensors inside the fuel tank. So in order to address the explosion issue or the fire triangle developing issue, they work on the first approach, which is the flammability reduction. Modern aircraft and the new manufactured aircraft are having about what it called a nitrogen generation system. We need to pour nitrogen inside the fuel tank to get rid from oxygen or air in order to allow the fuel tank not to be flammable. This is approach number one. And approach number two, even if the fuel tank are flammable, we need to assure that there is no ignition or ignition source may develop inside the fuel tank. And this is a big task for the maintenance engineer. You need to take care about your maintenance fuel tasks or maintenance aircraft fuel system tasks in order to assure that your work will not develop a spark inside the fuel tanks. So this is number two. We talk about the two approaches of the CDCCLs. What about number three? We will talk about the solutions or maintenance applications of the CDCCLs. I need to address all maintenance engineers that maintenance manuals, for example, aircraft maintenance manual, troubleshooting manuals, electrical standard practices manuals, are changed and they address in the manuals the CDCCL tasks. How you will know the CDCCL task in the aircraft maintenance manual? There will be a warning inside the task that will address the CDCCL design feature. And if you found any task or any aircraft fuel task addressed by this warning, you need to take care very much about this task. You need to bring back the design as it is before your work to prevent a spark to be generated inside the fuel tanks. So this is the three informations regarding CDCCL. We talk about what is the CDCCLs, the two approaches of the CDCCLs, and how we can play a role in the aviation industry to decrease the number of these occurrences. This is for pilots and the maintenance engineers. Thank you for your good listening and always fly safely and maintain your aircraft safely. Thank you and goodbye.